I'll tell you what, the news never stops with this football team. You're watching the San Francisco 49ers Report by Chat Sports. I am your host, Chase Sr. A couple of breaking news items to get to very quickly. Jalen Hurd, the former third-round pick, has been cut, and Odell Beckham Jr. going to the rival Los Angeles Rams. The 49ers could see him and the Rams on Monday Night Football at Levi's Stadium. We do start off with the news about Jalen Hurd, the rookie third-round pick from the 2019 NFL Draft, who had tantalizing potential coming out of Baylor as well as Tennessee, who has not played a single snap of regular season football for the San Francisco 49ers, has been let go. He missed his entire rookie year with a back injury, had to undergo surgery that year, and then missed his second season with a torn ACL. Going into training camp this year, the pressure was on him to make this 53-man roster, and the knee injuries continued to surface. He barely practiced at all throughout training camp. He only got on the field for that one preseason game, was able to catch a couple of balls, but then after making the 53-man roster, which was a surprise to me and a lot of other people out there, he was put on IR. Kyle Shannahn said a couple days ago he didn't expect him to come back for the 2021 NFL season, and with that, the organization is cutting ties with him. This is yet another NFL draft whiff for Kyle Shannahn and John Lynch. And since this regime took over, there have been a lot of misses in the NFL draft at some of the premium draft slots. You want to know why the 49ers are in this position right now, where they've lost 5 of 6, they're really struggling, can't find their footing or a form of consistency. They have had to rely on a lot of bubble type of players, older players on this roster right now, partially because a lot of their draft picks have not lived up to expectations, or some of those draft picks are not available because they're injured or no longer on the roster anymore. Now Jalen Hurd, one of those players, no longer on the roster. What's interesting here is that this move comes without an injury designation. So what this could mean, and I repeat, what this could mean is that Jalen Hurd went through a physical with the team. They deemed him healthy, but then they said, you know what? We're not going to move forward with you. We're going to cut bait. We're going to cut ties. And I honestly don't know at this point if Jalen Hurd is ever going to play a snap in the National Football League. Obviously, probably not ever again for the San Francisco 49ers. And he's been a player who has never played a regular season snap for this football organization. We're always going to have the Cowboys game in the preseason during his rookie year, where he caught a couple of touchdown passes, and you saw the tantalizing potential that Jalen Hurd had coming out of college. He started his collegiate career as a running back. He made the switch to wide receiver, put up big numbers for the Baylor Bears, and that's a big reason why the Niners pinpointed him in the third round back in 2019. And when you watched him play in that lone preseason game, he ran a couple of different routes, crossers, routes downfield. He was utilized as a red zone threat, a big-bodied wide receiver at 6'5", 229 pounds. You saw him in that moment, and you're like, wow, we might have a star at the wide receiver spot because of the diversity to his route tree, but also the very unique size at 6'5", 229 pounds at the wide receiver spot. He could line up outside. He could line up inside. That presented a bunch of different matchup problems, I should say, but all for naught, because Jalen Hurd only played that preseason game and another preseason game before getting let go by San Francisco today. So with that, Niner gang, I know you've been emotional about Jalen Hurd. You've been frustrated with his inability to stay on the field, just like me. What is your one-word reaction to him getting cut? Get those one-word reactions in the comment section right now. For me, my one-word reaction with Hurd getting cut, it's just unfortunate, because I really liked him coming out of college, and a lot of other teams across the National Football League liked him coming out of college. He had that positional versatility. I liked the background as a running back going to wide receiver who had tight end size, and because of that size, nowadays in the NFL, those physical attributes are very, very intriguing. And even in that preseason game this past year, where he didn't look explosive, he looked slow, he looked rusty, I expected that, you could at least see some of the potential that Kyle Shannahn and John Lynch saw. But when a player continuously gets hurt, and when a player continuously is unable to get on the field, at some point or another, whether you drafted him with a premium asset or not, You have to let him go. You have to move forward as an organization. Think about it from a business perspective. You might bring in and hire an employee who you think the world of. And at first, you're like, wow, we made a great hire here. We made a great draft pick. But if that employee is consistently either unavailable or continues to mess up in their day-to-day process as an employee, over time, you might say, yeah, they might have had potential at one point, but to get better as an organization, to get better as a business, it's best for us to move on. That is what San Francisco is doing. But there's no question, Jalen Hurd going down is yet another bust for Kyle Shannahn and John Lynch. This is why you subscribe to the 49ers Report by Chat Sports. We are growing very, very fast, and we're almost at 44,000 subscribers. When breaking news happens, we have you covered as soon as possible. We also give you free daily videos covering the latest news and rumors. So hit that red subscribe button down below or go to youtube.com/49ersTV. Some more breaking news to get to. It's been a wild day in 49er land. Faithful is certainly feeling that. Odell Beckham Jr. has signed with the Los Angeles Rams. There were differences in some of the reporting moments ago from guys like Adam Schefter and Ian Rappaport. There was a quote-unquote source off. I threw out a funny picture on my Twitter page, @Chase_Senior. You can see what I'm talking about. But Adam Schefter was right with the initial report that Odell Beckham Jr., who has a house in the Los Angeles area, is going to L.A. to team up with Matthew Stafford and Sean McVay. He tweeted this out on Thursday afternoon. Former Browns wide receiver Odell Beckham Jr. is finalizing a deal with the Los Angeles Rams. There were conflicting reports as to if the Rams and Packers were finalists, that OBJ had not made a final decision, but he has made his final decision. He is going to the NFC West rival Los Angeles Rams. It came down to two very good teams. And earlier on today, I had put together a list of the favorites to land OBJ. The Rams weren't on there, so they sneak in at the last minute, kind of like they came out of nowhere to trade for Von Miller on NFL trade deadline day, and they land this polarizing wide receiver. With the moves and trades of Von Miller and OBJ, it is clear that Les Snead, Sean McVay, this entire Rams organization believe that they have an opportunity to win a Super Bowl, and this is a Super Bowl swing type of move. The Rams and 49ers right now, two completely different organizations. You have the 49ers having lost 5 of 6 games, 11 of 12 games at home, having not won a home game since week 6 last year against the Los Angeles Rams. Unable to really find any form of consistency, this is an organization in San Francisco that is in a downward trajectory, and they don't seem to be Super Bowl contenders, whereas the Los Angeles Rams continue to be very, very aggressive as a football operations staff and as an organization, making big swings to try to bring back a Lombardi trophy. And how about on the same day that Jalen Hurd gets cut, Odell Beckham Jr. signs with the Rams? Not sure what the dollar figures are. Of course, we're recording this video right after the news of Jalen Hurd and OBJ going down. It is going to be a one-year deal for Odell Beckham Jr. So that means that if the 49ers are interested in him, if he shows some juice and pop in those legs, he is going to be a free agent and all other teams can bid on his services this offseason. This is a Rams offense that has already been very impressive this year, and now they add OBJ to the mix alongside some really good weapons on defense and Jalen Ramsey and Aaron Donald. Offensively, you have the number one wide receiver in terms of receiving yards, who's ahead of Debo Samuel by a tad in Cooper Kupp. You have Robert Woods, OBJ, and Matthew Stafford, who's certainly been slinging the rock. Who is OBJ going to be for Los Angeles? He's basically had two different careers. He got off to one of the best starts of any wide receiver in NFL history from 2014 to 2016. These are his per-season averages, 96 grabs, almost 1,400 yards, average yards per catch, a little less than 16, and he averaged almost 12 touchdowns per year. But in 2021, and really throughout his entire Cleveland Browns tenure, his production went down, his numbers slipped, and he got really, really frustrated with his role in the offense and the play of Baker Mayfield. He basically didn't do anything this year, coming off that torn ACL, 17 grabs, 232, average yards per catch going down to 13.5. You could see OBJ in a Rams uniform on Monday night against the Niners in what has become a must-win game for San Francisco if they have any hopes of making it to the playoffs. I know people watching are like, playoffs? Playoffs? You're talking about playoffs? Yeah, well, the Niners are still realistically in that playoff contention window. They're going to have to get a win against the Rams and maybe even OBJ with this depleted secondary on Sunday. Before I get out of here, hey, speak up, sound off. Are you bummed OBJ signed with Los Angeles, or do you think he's washed? Type Y for yes, I'm bummed. Type N for no. Get those votes in. And as always, Niner Gang, we appreciate you. Thanks for watching today's show.